Hey, what is up, everybody? Michael Crump back here again, talking about the latest and the greatest in PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 5, homebrew news, and much, much more. So today, I want to explore building a package just like the one that you see on the screen right here that allows you to play any type of movie files directly on your PlayStation 4. So let's just go ahead and let's jump straight into it. So the first thing that you will need to do is you will need to head over to this MediaFire link and download PS4 Movie Maker version 1.0. So just press here and you should have that on your computer. Once you have that, go ahead and extract it. In my example right here, I just extracted mine to my C drive. You can put that wherever you would like. The other thing is that I would highly recommend that you use PowerShell in Windows in order to compile the final fake package file. So I just went ahead and I typed in PowerShell in the Windows search, and then I just went ahead and ran it as administrator. Now, again, the full code to the BAT file is obviously available, and you can open that up and take a look at it before you run it, if you just want to make sure that it's not going to do anything malicious to your computer. Okay, so once you have everything extracted and you are inside of that folder, inside of PowerShell, let's just do a quick DIR in order to verify that everything is there, and it is. You will see there is a .bat file, or this is a Windows batch file, as well as there is a folder there that's called tools. And basically, this just has the tools needed in order to create the fake package. So we need to run the bat file. So if you begin by typing a capital P and an S and then press the tab button, then it will autocomplete for you. And at this point, just go ahead and press the return button. Okay, so you will see that there are a couple of different options here. The very first one is what we will be taking, and that is to make a PKG video based off of an MP4 file that we already have. The second option is to make a package video based off of MPK, AVI, or a couple of other formats. The third option is that if you want to convert an MKV or an AVI file to MP4, you do that. And then number four is going to install the .NET Framework 5.0 if you get any sort of error. So what I would recommend is to go ahead and try to run it first. And if you do get an error, basically if you take option four, it brings you to a website, and then you just download install .NET Framework 5.0. Okay, so we're going to begin by taking option number one here. So let's take option number one and we'll press return. It says to change the ID of the package. So here is where you're basically going to want to just go ahead and give it a random number. Obviously, you don't want to reuse an ID of an application or game that you already have installed. So I just randomly chose 23422. Once that's complete, just go ahead and press enter. And now it's going to ask for the name of the movie. So whatever you title it here, that's how it's going to show up on your PlayStation 4. So just give it whatever title that you would like. I'm just going to name mine Michael Crump. And the reason that I'm just going to name mine Michael Crump is actually I'm just going to use an existing video that I have in order for this test. Now it's asking you to drag and drop the movie's cover and press enter. And so what I did for this part of it was that I used the actual thumbnail, the high resolution thumbnail that I used on YouTube, and just named it cover.png. I don't think that this name matters at all. If we go into it, you can see that it is just a high resolution version of that thumbnail. Now, it does state down at the bottom that you can drag and drop the movie cover there, but I couldn't get that to work. So if you can't get it to drag and drop, you can always just come up here and click and then Control C and then back over into your PowerShell instance. You can simply hit Control V a slash and then the first letter and press tab, then it will autocomplete. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's just press return here. And it has copied over the file. And now it's saying, can you drag and drop your movie file and press enter? Again, this is just simply this file right here. Again, on my machine, it did not copy over. So I'm just going to use the same method that I used just a moment ago. One thing to keep in mind is that if you autocomplete, get rid of these quotes there. And once that's done, you can just head back to the end of the line or wherever and press the return key, and it should start building a package. So we'll press a key there, and there we can see that it is building our package right now. Okay, so outside of a few little warnings, it looks like our package file is ready. So let's head over to Windows Explorer. Okay, and so there we go. We have a michaelcrump.pkg file that is right around 1 gigabyte, which the uncompressed YouTube video that I made was right around 1 gigabyte. So let's go ahead and let's take that and let's just copy that over to our USB drive and get it inserted into our PlayStation 4. Okay, over on the PlayStation 4, I am in the folder that I copied that PKG to. So let's go ahead now and let's press the X button on that PKG. Okay, very cool. I like this. So obviously it resized the image that I submitted. We can see also the title ID has those fake numbers that I just came up with. And it looks like this is pretty much ready to go. So let's just go ahead and press the X button here. Okay, added to downloads. And then we'll switch back to the dashboard here. Okay, we are ready to go. Let's go ahead and start. And there it is. The video that I included is running properly. So it looks like this package is a nice little addition to being able to run movies of any type onto your PlayStation 4. So I do want to see if I can do things such as rewind or fast forward. And it appears as if the square button is just bringing it back to the beginning. So I'm sure there is some additional functionality that the developers will be adding into this package to allow you to maybe do things such as, you know, stop or play the video again, because that's some features that I think would be awesome to have. And we'll just go ahead and take a look at the information here. Okay, and there is not a lot to see there. Now, obviously, what's the difference between this and potentially, you know, just putting a file on a USB stick and then navigating out using one of the players that I've mentioned in previous videos? Well, I think it's just obviously the ease of use by just running the application versus going into the media app, connecting a USB storage, going in looking for the file, and then playing it. Obviously, there will need to be other things that's included in this package, such as the ability to stop, playback, or to play, or rewind, or fast forward. Obviously, subtitle support would be nice as well, but just something to explore, and I'm sure we will see lots of advancements in this in the future. So again, thank you so very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Michael, out!